In this video, shared by Dr. Daniel Louzada from São Paulo, Brazil, we will discuss the surgical technique for managing diabetic tractional retinal detachment. This is the case of a patient with tractional retinal detachment due to proliferative diabetic retinopathy, for which surgical treatment with vitrectomy was indicated. We can observe a total retinal detachment with multiple areas of traction at the posterior pole due to fibrovascular proliferation. After the separation of the peripheral vitreous, the surgeon performs vitreous base shaving. Next, the traction points at the posterior pole are addressed by segmenting the traction areas of the arcades with the vitrector. This relieves the retinal traction exerted by the fibrovascular proliferation areas. Perfluorocarbon is used for posterior pole stabilization. The delamination of preretinal membranes is then performed using a bimanual technique with retinal forceps and curved scissors. Perfluorocarbon acts as a third hand for the surgeon, protecting the posterior pole from the traction exerted on the membranes. It is crucial to find an appropriate dissection plane for the scissors to avoid iatrogenic retinal tears. Care must be taken when using the scissors, as an iatrogenic retinal tear can make it much more difficult to remove the hyaloid, compromising the postoperative prognosis. As the membranes are released, we can observe an improvement in the retinal appearance. The main challenge in these cases is to find the correct dissection plane for the membranes, as the retina underneath is detached, which makes inadvertent tears more likely. It is important to address the traction bridges from the preretinal membranes to the retina so that they can be removed in one piece with minimal traction on the retinal tissue. At this point, perfluorocarbon is added. Panretinal photocoagulation is then performed with the endolaser probe under perfluorocarbon. A fluid air exchange is done, and laser treatment is applied to the entire peripheral retina. At the end of the surgery, silicone oil is injected. A good anatomical result can be observed in the late postoperative period.